The 501st Legion was perhaps the most feared unit in the entire Grand Army of the Republic during the Clone Wars, and its reputation only increased once the war ended. Nicknamed Vader's Fist, the 501st spent the first years of the Empire leading the Jedi Purge, and developed a fearsome reputation both for its role in storming the Jedi Temple and in hunting down survivors. But over time, the reputation of the 501st began to decline, and as the Empire grew older, the 501st became less prominent and less feared. In this video, we'll be analyzing this decline. The 501st Legion was originally just another brigade in the Grand Army of the Republic, part of the original detachment that saw action on Geonosis. It had a high concentration of extremely skilled clones, and so early in the war, Supreme Chancellor Palpatine decided to transform it into an elite unit, where the most skilled and most ruthless clones in the Grand Army would be transferred to. He put this legion under the personal command of newly knighted Jedi General Anakin Skywalker, who alongside Captain Rex led the legion to many victories in the Clone Wars. Skywalker, Rex, and eventually Commander Appo kept the 501st in tip-top shape, constantly transferring in new troopers that showed promise. The legion developed a reputation as being ruthlessly efficient, and they won battle after battle during the war, often against formidable odds. Detachments of the 501st Legion were often called away to do specialized tasks for the Supreme Chancellor himself, as was seen many times at the end of the war. The most notable mission undertaken by the 501st came at the very end of the Clone Wars, Operation Nightfall. Under the direct command of Darth Vader and Commander Appo, the 501st Legion marched into the Jedi Temple and slaughtered the Jedi that were present inside, killing thousands in a fairly short period of time. But Operation Nightfall was only the first mission that the 501st would undertake as part of the Great Jedi Purge, the first of many. After the mission to Mustafar and the end of the Clone Wars, the 501st Legion became Darth Vader's personal unit, which he led alongside the feared Commander Appo. It gained the well-earned nickname of Vader's Fist and led the Imperial effort to wipe out the Jedi from the face of the galaxy. 501st Stormtroopers fought Jedi fugitives on Kessel, Mokana, Kashyyyk, and many other worlds, and became so skilled at it that they became the go-to unit for whenever a Jedi was reported. To add to the unit's fame, Vader reorganized all of the ARC troopers and clone commandos that remained in the military after the Clone Wars into a special operations unit that was attached to the 501st, bolstering its reputation as the best of the best. Throughout the Dark Times, the 501st was dispatched on all number of missions. They dealt with early rebellions, separatist holdouts, the Kaminoan clone uprising, and fugitive Jedi across the galaxy. And when the Alliance to Restore the Republic began to form, they were one of the first units deployed against them. The stormtroopers of the 501st Legion were responsible for boarding the Tantive IV and also led the Empire on some of its most important victories in the Galactic Civil War at Yavin 4 and Hoth. However, the 501st Legion was also present at the Empire's worst defeat. It was the 501st Legion that manned the Empire's shield generator base on the forest moon of Endor, and it was the stormtroopers of the 501st that were slaughtered by Endor's native Ewoks. It was one of the Empire's most humiliating moments, and the 501st was all but destroyed during it. It was reorganized afterward, and it remained an integral part of the Empire even into the Legacy era, but it was never the same again. So, our question is this: how did the 501st Legion go from being the elite stormtroopers that were the first to respond to reports of Jedi fugitives to being slaughtered by living teddy bears? Though it may not seem like it just by looking at the unit's history, the process began long before the base on Endor was even built. The first major blow to the 501st actually came in only a few weeks after the end of the Clone Wars. During an early battle on Kashyyyk, in which the Legion battled the Wookiees and a group of fugitive Jedi, Rowan Shrine successfully managed to kill Commander Appo. Appo was a significant and underappreciated part of the 501st's efficiency during the Jedi Purge. He was a ruthless, efficient, and skillful commander, so much so that even Darth Vader took a liking to him. With his death, the quality of the 501st began its slow decline, as his replacement commanders were never quite as skilled as he had been. The next early hit the 501st took was a more literal one: rising casualties. You lose a lot of men trying to kill Jedi, and the 501st regularly lost significant amount of men during the Jedi Purge. Battles like the Battle of Otoa only made this worse. In that disaster, two entire battalions of the 501st Legion were killed, in large part due to the betrayal of Imperial commandos. The veteran clones of the 501st that were killed in the action were replaced by newer, less skilled clones, and despite Vader's best efforts, this only got worse. As we mentioned above, the 501st Legion participated in the takedown of the Kaminoan Clone Rebellion in 12 BBY. Though they were very successful in that battle, it nonetheless was a blow to the Empire. Fearful of a repeat, the Empire gradually began phasing out Kaminoan cloning for the Stormtrooper Corps, using other cloning centers and other templates, and eventually outright recruits. Though the 501st remained pure Fett clones for a while, the Fett clones they got were inferior to the originals and the quality of the 501st Stormtroopers began to decline pretty rapidly. Aging also became a problem for Vader's Fist. The clone troopers employed by the Republic and later the Empire aged at an accelerated rate, and by the time of the Galactic Civil War, veterans of the Clone Wars or even the reconquest of the Rim were scarce. Even the Kaminoan clones in the 501st were much less skilled than the originals in the unit due to the lack of experience and also due to the degradation of Kaminoan training standards. Ultimately, however, it was the recruits that doomed the 501st. According to the 501st journal from Star Wars Battlefront 2, the 501st remained purely Fett clones, but the movies show that this was no longer true by the time of the original trilogy. Though Stormtrooper recruits had to meet a very narrow set of physical requirements, they were vastly inferior to the original clones, if much easier to produce. The influx of these new Stormtroopers into the 501st Legion, and indeed the whole Stormtrooper Corps, led to a massive decrease in effectiveness, which ultimately led Vader's Fist into its final reckoning on Endor. So, that's why the quality of the 501st Legion decreased during Imperial times. As some of you probably know, the 501st shares its name with a real-life fan organization, which was formed back in the 80s and currently has over 3,000 members in 40 different countries. The fan organization actually came first. It was Timothy Zahn that made them an official part of the Star Wars Expanded Universe in 2004 in homage to the group, and their history was elaborated on in Battlefront 2. But what do you guys think? Do you think we missed any causes of the 501st decline? As per usual, post your thoughts in the comments section below. And you guys know the drill, make sure you check out all the links in the description below to join the wider Geetsleys community on our Geetsleys Gaming Network and on all of our Discords. So they are all linked in the description below. And if you want to help me out even more than you already are by watching these videos, then checking out my Patreon would be greatly appreciated, as any dollar helps, as I'm doing this full time now. So I want to give a big thank you to all my current patrons. And if you are feeling generous enough to become a patron yourself, then that would be greatly appreciated, guys. Anyways, as always, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.